Hello creative designers and welcome on to this studio. My name is Peter and on to this studio you just going to see how we can be able to add a WooCommerce wallet system in your e-commerce website. The wallet system will work when they have the wallet top up or the wallet has the amount, whatever, either by transaction, by different, or whatever the transaction happened, that the account has been created, the amount, they can be able to use it to shop. They can even top up on maybe a transaction. They can be able even to transfer to another account the money, the amount of the money. So whatever I'm just trying to tell you is that when you go to the e-commerce, to the dashboard, and we go to the Tel wallet and you just click the Tel wallet here, you'll be able to see all the users here and you'll be able to see the remaining balance, and you can even see the email and their name. The thing is that you can see the transact, the amount that is remaining, and on click here you'll be able to even on this eye icon here, you'll be able to see all the transaction that happened on this account or on it. You can see we created 1,000, it was created 1,000, which had a top up of 1,200, and we debit 400. Now we have, the account is having a total balance of 800. On that, when you just open another account, you can see it will just summarize and give all the transactions that happened with that account. The other thing is that if you want to top up account, you just need to click here. If you you have to create the account, you have to create the account, or just need to do is, if you as an admin, you just want to create this account, all you just need to do is you click on this gear icon and click on it. You'll be directed to this page where you'll be able now to credit the account. You just have to enter the amount you just want to credit. Is it a credit or a debit? When you just created an account, is that means that you top up the account. When you just debit, that say you have deducted the amount you just going to include here. So if you just say, if you decide now it's about credit, you have now to enter the reason. Maybe you say for reversal, and that when you just click save here, you receive an email, or the user will receive an email and say thank you for using the wallet, and you say 100 has been credited to the wallet, and you can see the total amount here. And I'll also show you how you can be able to customize this custom text here before the end of this tutorial. Let's see now how will it look like when you just go to the user account. So I need to open this in a private tab here, window, and I just need to log in. Upon login, I just click account here, and I just need to log in here, and I just click login here. With that, we are in the after successful login, now you have been directed to my account. This is where all the data for my account will be held here. So when the customer click on my wallet, he will be able to see all the transactions that just happened, the one we did for the reversal, the date and the amount. And on top here you have the total balance, the total account balance, and we have the wallet deferred, wallet for transfer. You can see it transferred, and you can see it has even a different color with the top up, and the other one was debit, and we also have the reverse. You'll be able to see all that. If you want to top up the account, you also need to click on this button here. You enter the amount you want to top up, click on here, and you need to complete it as a transaction, and the account will be credited that amount. The thing is the wallet transfer. He can be able to transfer from one wallet, from one customer to another. When just customer, will just need to know the email for the other user he want to transfer to. So we have it here, and to search from the database and get the email. Once you get the email and verify it is, you just click on it. You have the amount you just want to transfer, and the reason we say this is a test too, because I did another test before, and click on this proceed to transfer, and they have another email here. You have said your credit, the amount has been credited to your wallet. Yeah. From there, the other thing is the transaction. You have the summary of every transaction happened. If it's just a credit, it will just say here, this was just a credit, and the detail for the credit, or the reason why the credit happened. You'd also see the debit and all that, then the reason. You can even get to see the dates here. You can choose on specific date to see on the past days. If what the transaction he did, the user will have this chance now to earn from your website by using a referral links. By using these referral links, the user will need only to copy this link here. And if you set up for a successful sign up, the amount will be shown here, and it will also be added to the total balance for that account. That's what we are going to learn in this tutorial. And without further ado, let's just get into action and I show you how we're going to do it. Now we have to get to the dashboard menu, and we have to get to the dashboard or the back end of our website. And on the dashboard scroll, we have the plugin, because we need to install this plugin. It's a free plugin. So on hover on the plugin, we have these three options. Select the add new button, because we need to add a new plugin. If you have installed it, you can skip this. Use the timestamp in the description to skip this. Here we say we want Terra Wallet. Upon typing wallet, there are so many suggestions included here, and the one that you're going to use is called Terra Wallet for WooCommerce. We install the plugin. You can see it has more than 30 active installation. Last updated 2 months ago, it had a 5-star out of more than 100 people who has taken time to rate this product. After successful installation of the product, we activate the plugin. After successful installation of the plugin, we activate the plugin. With that, now you can start from here, but let's just close it here and we just go to the dashboard menu. Now you have the button for the Terra Wallet, and just click on it and select Terra Wallet. On Terra Wallet, you can see it just shares the users that are available and the amount, and if you just want to create from here, you can just credit it. Now the other thing you need to check out is the setting. On click to the setting, now you are going to be able to set the general status, general setting, and you also have the credit option. On the general setting, you're just going to set so many things. So first of all, we start the general setting, and on the general setting, this is where now you just want to give the name that will be used when someone want to recharge their product, their wallet. They call it product title, but these are the way when the customer want to top up the wallet, what is that word that will be written here. You can decide to add a custom word or use the one that we have. The other thing is you can change this icon here. Yeah. If you have an image, all you just need to do is select product image, and you'll be directed to the image library or the media library. And if you don't have one, maybe let me use like this one here, you can be able to change, and once you update it, it will just change the logo here. So from there, now we proceed to where we have the minimum top up. You can set the minimum top up for this wallet and say this is a minimum top up you can top up for. This is a minimum top up you can top up your wallet. But I'm not going to set the minimum or the maximum, because here we have the minimum and maximum. So once you set here, one cannot be able to top up below that minimum. If you say the wallet minimum that can be top up is $100, one cannot be able to top up less than $100. Even if you say the maximum one can top up is $1,000, one cannot be able to top up more than $1,000. But it's always good not to limit your customer, but a lot depend on your taste and preference. What are the location? What are the location of the wallet? Do you want it to be seen on the primary menu? This is a primary menu here. You can set it. If you wanted to set on the secondary menu, it all depends on where you have the menu that you just want to use. There are people who want to use the primary menu or even the secondary menu. It all depends on how you want it. And the other thing, you can set it off canvas menu, and you can also allow only the logged in user account menu can be seen, or even on the footer menu. It all depends on how you just want it to be set. The other thing is auto deduct wallet, but for partial payment. Yeah, if you check this one, that means that if someone pays less than what is needed to purchase a product, it will just automatically deduct the other top up amount from the wallet. So if you take this one, it will start doing that automatically. Do you want to allow wallet transfer? Wallet transfer comes when one wants to transfer money from one user to the other one. If you want to allow that, this one here, then the way it just need to be done is one need to search the email and enter the amount, the reason, and it proceed to transfer the money from one wallet to the other. You can allow that. Maybe people can be able people can surprise each other, and maybe the customer can even surprise the other, or can help other to maybe do the top up and purchase. The other thing is the minimum transfer amount. You can set the minimum that can be transferred from one account to the other. So here we have the transfer charge. Charge type, do you want to have fixed or percentage? If you say percentage, you say I want to take maybe 1% or 2% of the amount that is being transferred. So if someone transferred $100, it will be deducted maybe $1 or $10, depending on the percentage you have set. If you want to set the fixed amount to be deducted, then you have to come here and say I want to deduct maybe $2 or $1 per transaction. That will be done to transfer the money from one account to the other, or from one user to the other one. So if you say that if someone transfer even $1,000 or $10,000, it doesn't affect this amount will still remain as fixed. So it all depends on how you want to earn money, how you just want to wish, or how you wish it to be done. So payment, check payment, you can allow this one, then save changes. So from there, now we proceed to the credit option. So do you want to allow credit reward program and program gateway charge? So first of all, the first one you're going to start is called Run Cashback Reward Program to your website. That means that you're going to give money back to the customer, either by credit card or whatever it takes. Like, you are going to pay back the customer. Maybe maybe you want to return the money maybe for an order that was not delivered, or maybe you want a product was delivered faulty. This is where you're going to allow the cashback. So when do you want to process a cashback? We say the order must be completed for us to pay the cashback. Most of the time, I would prefer you have the completed order to be given a cashback, or you can even allow some processing. I have done a tutorial on how you can be able to add a limited unlimited order status or for free without using a plugin. I'll include the link on the description. Consider checking it out. The other thing is cashback rule. Yeah, so when you just offer the cashback, what do you want it to be? On which form or how do you want it to happen? Do you want it to happen in a cart wise, product wise, or category wise? So let it be a cart wise. So the other thing is cashback type. Do you want a percentage or fixed? Let me include the percentage. Cashback amount, enter the cashback amount you want to give and just leave it blank, not limit the cashback. Now we have the minimum cart amount on this position here. Now you're just going to set that rule that will govern on the cashback, that you say if the cart didn't have this minimum amount, you're not going to offer the cashback. So I'm not just going to just tip it. If you say $10, that means if the cart didn't have more than $10, they cannot be able to request for cashback. So I'll leave it as blank, not to limit the customer. Sometimes customer is always late, so it's always good to hear the feedback from the customer, or even hear and give the feedback to every customer. So the other thing is maximum cash amount. This is opposite for this one. If you said that the cart had more than $100, and someone, maybe if you said the minimum cart amount is $100 and someone cart has $200, he won't be able to have a cashback. But I will leave it blank as it is. The other thing is cashback gateway charge. If you said this one, this will be the amount that will be deducted once you do the cashback. So if you this one, we have the charge type, we have fixed and you have the percentage. If you say is a percentage and you say 1% and you give a cashback to the customer of $100, the customer will be deducted $1 as a percentage or as a payment gateway charge. So, or else if you say you want fixed, that means that it will not limit in one. Once you even transact a cashback over $10,000 and you set here you'll be deducting $10, this $10 will be deducted on fixed, it will be deducted to every transaction that you do. So I just leave it as blank like that. So from there, I think we're done with it. Let's see how what we have just created. So I need to just open my website here. Let's go to my account here and I select my wallet. Once someone wants to top up the account, they have this menu here. It will be included on my account. You'll be able to see this button for my wallet. Once they click on wallet top up, they just only need to top up it to the amount they just want to top up here and proceed to make a purchase. It will be a normal, like the normal order, and once it's done, the top up will be done. So from there we have the wallet transfer. Customer be able to transfer the amount. I did it on the intro. We did it on, and we saw how one can be able to. The other thing is he can have the transaction that has been done. So we are missing something here, the referrals. And the way you can be able to activate the referrals is you go back to the Terra wallet and we select action. On the action setting here, we are now going to set the new registration. If someone has sign up to your website, they'll be able to earn amount. So you need to just click the setup and you enable, and you say this amount that you're going to reward to this new user, maybe to buy work for coming a member. And then here you can add a custom text here and click save. We go back here. And if for product review, daily visit, you can set that. The one that I just wanted to set is for referrals. The referrals are those links that are going to be shared from your account. Once someone used the link, and one can invite another user, another person to come and just be a new user to your website. And once it's done, they will be able to earn some amount. So there are so many programs there that are offering referrals. This is how it works. So if you enable for this referral here, this one is for referring a visitor. This one will be long. You can end up losing no money. End up losing a lot of money, because if someone can refer just a visitor to just come and visit your website without doing the sign up, and then you pay them, that maybe cannot add more value. But I will not use this one. I like to use this one here. So the one that we are going to is for referring sign up. So here I'm just going to remove this one amount. If someone is referring a visitor, he'll earn nothing. And now here we have the referring signups. This is for the successful signups after the referral. So the amount that you're going to offer should be here, and minimum order amount for you to be do the payout. I can just leave it at zero, but if you say, you can say one need to have a 5 minimum order for you to pay, and the other thing is the limit. You can offer a limit per day, per week. If you say per day, you have to indicate here how many times one can refer, and weekly and all that, but I'll say no limit. And you add the description here, and the referral format you can use user or referral ID, username as referral ID like that, or you can use referral ID like that. It all depends on how you do it. You can check on them and see how the referral link look like. Let's see first of all the username referral ID. We save it and we refresh here. Now we have the button for referrals. Once now this is how it look like. Yeah, so with the name of the user, one can copy this to the clipboard and share to the members. Let's see now the other thing is from numeric referral ID when we save the changes. And we refresh here. So let's see how it look like. So to have this one, the other one had in my username. So it all depends on how you just want to. So there, I think customer will be able to see if the referral visitor, the successful sign up, and the total earning. With that, you have been able to set up a complete wallet to the website. The total amount will be seen here. The credit for the account will be seen here on the top here. So if you don't see this here, you can be able to add it, like you go to appearance and you go to the menu and check. Let's check if we have the wallet here. We don't have it. Now what all you just need to do is you find it mostly here on WooCommerce endpoint, select wallet and add to the menu. Once you have it, you can add, depending on the theme you're using or whatever, you can add a custom text, but I'm just going to leave it the way it is. Scroll here, select primary menu or the secondary menu, depending on the menu on where you just want it to be presented, and you save the setting. So once we refresh here, we're just going to have two wallet here. Now they have the button for my wallet, and on click they will be directed to this point here, and they'll be able to see the balance and all that we have just checked. After now we are done with the setting up everything, all you just need to do is set up the custom image, custom email. So what you just need to do is you come to WooCommerce and select setting on offer. On WooCommerce you see all this option, select setting, After now, you select setting, come here to emails. Here you have so many other emails you can customize, but the one you just want to customize is the new wallet transaction and low wallet balance. And let's see what is this is for about, but we are going to select these three and see how we can be able to customize them. So the first one is manage. So the first one is for the new account ones. So the one say is for yours has been created, will come, and that you can customize and add the email, custom email, but that we're not looking for that. We're going to set the one for wallet transaction and select manage. Here you see you can customize it. Here you see it has your site title here, and your wallet transaction and transaction date. And the other thing is the email wallet here, and you can customize if you want it to be plain text, multi, and you can select. If you select multi parts, you need to just go, you can view the template here. Let's see how it look like. So I want to use the plain text here, and I save the changes. You can add your custom text here, in here, and the other one is, I don't think there's any other thing you can be able to set from there. I think I have to go to much deeper tutorial. So about this one, and you can see the low water balance here, and you can see all you just need to do, you have enabled it, and the threshold for the water balance, you can see maybe $100 or maybe 10 or maybe whatever it is, you can set up. And the subject to the for the email is your site title, wallet balance is low, please recharge your wallet. You can add a custom message here and type it. Once you just done with it, all you just need to do is you save the setting. You just that you have been able to customize the setting, that you have been able to customize the email just so easy. All you just need to do is follow that simple step and you achieved the best. Did you find the tutorial helpful to you? If you did find, hit the thumbs up. If you are new here to this YouTube channel, consider subscribing. Until next time, thank you.